A model village is a bit like a regular village, only smaller. And I think that's why I like them, because I have a lot of experience with things that are smaller than they're meant to be. This is Merrivale Model Village in Great Yarmouth. It's got everything a good model village needs. It's got model people, model houses, model cars, model trains, stupid joke signs. Do you get the joke? Because it's a dentist and his name is Dr. McCavity, and people go to dentists because they have cavities. Oh, Britland and your humour. And of course, koi carp. I don't know exactly what it is, but model villages are absolutely amazing to me. They're cool to look at, they're colourful, they're fun, they're pretty. Look at these flowers, these are especially pretty. There's all these little stories everywhere as well. You've got people dancing around a maypole, you got some scouts or guides, like, doing scouty, guidey, campy stuff. You got this lovely, lovely proposal scene, and then this wedding. It's so pretty, it's so cool, I love it. There's someone bungee jumping here. At least I hope they're bungee jumping, because if they're not, they're being tortured. And I didn't report it to the tiny police, which makes me guilty by association, I think. I don't really know what association means. Here's a nice group of nuns singing a nice song. I wonder if they know their church fell down. I don't want to tell them. This is a big castle. Technically, this is a small castle, actually, now that I think about it. But in model village terms, it's a big castle. There's just a bit of normal castle stuff going on here. You got a bit of blacksmithing, you got a bit of knight training, a bit of witch murdering, a little bit of jestering, and then you got a bit of, I don't think we can show this here. Can we? Can we show this? Who am I asking? There's no one else here. Here is an art. I think it's a giraffe made of Play-Doh. I hope it's a giraffe made of Play-Doh because that's amazing. Radio-controlled cars are fun too. That doesn't really have anything to do with model villages, but this model village has radio-controlled cars, so kinda counts. Here's some mushroom houses and some fairy doors, just in case the realism was getting too much for you. All of the best model villages have toy trains going everywhere, and this one has lots. This train even has a meerkat and a plant pot. Hooray! They've got their own little train yard and they go absolutely everywhere. But my favourite is they go across this bridge across the pond in the middle. And it's awesome! Watching the trains go around is super duper relaxing as well. And there's also this really big observation wheel which is pretty cool. It's 12 real feet tall. That's like so many model feet. Your ticket gives you entry for the whole day, and I think it also gives you entry for the next day, but I can't actually remember. So I really recommend coming back in the evening, because they switch all the lights on, and there's pretty lights on the floor, and it's just pretty. I tried to get some good photos and videos of the place at nighttime, but I'm terrible at nighttime video science. So here's a couple of the clips I did get. Thank you very much for joining me on my adventure through this model village. This video was really fun to make. I got to go to a cool place and sit in my cool room and wave my arms around like some sort of idiot. What do you think about this style of video? Do you prefer this, like where it's more structured and I'm sat in front of the camera talking and showing you the clips of the things that I've done? Or do you prefer the videos where I just go and point my camera at stuff and hope for the best? I'm really trying to work out, you know, what I can do to make these better. If you can think of any interesting places for me to go, please let me know in the comments below. I'm always looking for interesting things to go and look at. But anyway, that's me done for today, so I will see you next time. Goodbye. Boop.